Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Silent Age. We are continuing with the main story. I mean, there is only one story, so yeah, we are continuing with the story. And the next chapter is Chapter 6, The Island. Having recovered the time traveler's name and address from the morgue, Joe arrives at the shore of Lake Chrichton in search of the enigmatic Reginald Lambert. And honestly, I mean, the guy went into the morgue, actually the hospital, to try and find him, and well, through sheer luck, he found him, but he was dead. So he's now going to talk to him in the present, and let's hope things go well. Anyhow, I'm pretty sure we would have to keep jumping in the between the past and the, you know, sorry, the present and the future. So let's go and address this level then. Chapter 6, The Island. Danger, crocodiles, loose swimming. Danger, oh come on, crocodiles? It's pretty obvious Lambert doesn't like visitors, but that sign is really over the top. This isn't exactly Florida. If you say so. Pretty sure there's going to be something at the back door, I feel like. Ah, mechanical jack. Okay, let's see what we have here. No.
Nice.
Ooh, mechanical jack. This will definitely come in handy. I'm actually not sure what it is. Wait, there's a usage description on the side. Attached to swing. Oh great, it's an enema pump. The fuel cap. I wonder why there's plenty of gas left. Okay. It's still got at least half a tank of gas. I guess we can use... Wow, this thing's got some wicked suction. It's full of gas now. Don't know why we would need to do that, but alright. Backup ambulance, I doubt it has anything. There's nothing else in here but a few blankets. Parked ambulance, don't really need it. I'm not going back to the city until I find Lambert. Now, here's what I noticed. The time travel device is discharged right now, and that means that this current chapter will be taking place completely in the present. So, no time shifting mechanics here. The box and the label are pretty faded from the sun, so I can't make out who it's from, to or from. It's been sitting out here a pretty long time. There's nobody will care if I take a peek inside. A trophy for outstanding excellence in the field of experimental physics. I wouldn't drink out of it, but if the last few hours taught me anything, it's that I'll probably find some use for it. boy. Oh, Lambert. This is definitely the right place. And I doubt he's gonna read his mail. There's nothing else in there. It's a beautiful place. I mean, if anything that I've understood about this... Ah, no, whatever, we need that. If there's anything that I understood about this game, it's that it has some striking visuals. Alright, it should be full now. Flooded. Oh, okay. So we use this to drain the water. All drained and no holes at the bottom either. I guess it was all just rainwater. Boots. No oars. I need to get the motor going. Yeah, that's why I use the fuel pump. That should do it. Good. Boot. Well, let's boot over to his face.
When I was a little lad, and so my mother told me, way haul away, we'll haul away Joe.
And we're here. I really like the moon in the background over there and the blue fading into the yellow over here. It's really pretty. Okay, crocodiles. Right, I get it. Lambert likes his privacy. But these crocodile signs are really laying it on a bit thick. I guess we don't need to read the sign or anything. Those spikes are unusually pointy. Almost as if someone had them sharpened on purpose. Okay, so how do we get around this? This job needs a jack, not a joke. No way I can bend these parts to squeeze through. Alright. Man, that jack really did the trick. I should be able to squeeze through now. Okay, there is a croc there. Lambert sure takes his gardening seriously. These are some quality shears. Now, what I would like to do is probably just cut a hole in here. Well, the shears are history, but at least I managed to make a decent knee-sized hole. Alright, let's go through the hole. We want to avoid the crocodile. I suppose this is where Lambert lives. Oh, it's a goldfish. A sundial.
Hey.
Very classy. That's a big, bright fish down there. Yeah, I sort of want to fish pond. It's a small fish pond. Now, I think I need to activate this, but I don't want to fry the fish at the same time, so I need some way to open this up, like pick this back up. Let's check over on this side. There's a grill there. I wonder if it has anything. It has tongs. Yuck, somebody forgot to clean up the grill. Okay, let's use the tongs with... I can't reach it, but that's... I can reach it, but that sucker is still too fast for me. Okay, use the tongs with the fish. Okay. Junction box. It's locked, thankfully. Thankfully, it did not just turn on the power. Camper door. Lucky me, it's open. Well, what do you know? Lucky you indeed. I was expecting it to be closed, to be honest. Excuse me there. I like how it says darkness all around. Like, this game doesn't skip out on the basic obvious stuff, such as switching on the light. And there's an electronic component here. It's some kind of electronic thing. Very astute. There's a lot of electronic parts in there, none of which I recognize. It's a drawing. Oh, that's probably the key to the junction box. It looks like blueprints for the still. I wonder what a still is. It's some kind of small key. I wonder what it proves with the junction box outside, probably. Looks like Lambert been cooking up some moonshine in here. Ah. The distillery. Still. I see. Lambert must like his hooch. I was trying to get this bottle, but alright. I suppose we need to kill the fishy to distract the croc, then. It is open now. Alright. Well, the fishy is now dead. I'm really sorry, big guy. Okay, time to turn you off. And yeah. Got the fish. There are apparently some switches here, but I guess they just... traffic lights. We are dangerously close to the croc. Right there. Use fish with the crocodile. Whoa, time out. What the? How? Okay, maybe we put it in the garden box? If I had to bury it, I think a burial at sea would be most appropriate. Then what do we do with the fish? Dead fish. Here we go. Now shoot. See you later in a while. That's a polite croc. That's a very polite croc. Oh, that's a chainsaw. It's a firewood. And a chainsaw. Did you miss the chainsaw? Of course you did. Figures. I finally come across something useful like a chainsaw, and of course there's a gas in it. But why would there be? It's locked. With the crocodile guarding my door, I'd probably keep it locked at all times too. How does it get out of the house though? Now what do we use the chainsaw with? Maybe we use it with the patrol, the boat? Gasoline for my American friends. I'm not going back before I find Lambert, so how do I get the fuel to use this? The moonshine. I could probably use that as fuel. I filled it up with alcohol from the distillery. I sure hope this works. Or still, to be exactly precise. Alright, time to cut through the store. Oh man. I mean, that adds a new dimension to breaking and entering, if you ask me. Front door should be open now. Yes, it is. And that was that for Chapter 6, the island. It was yet another short level and very intuitive puzzles. Of course, there were no time traveling mechanics in this level because it's nighttime. Our time travel device is not charged up even a bit. So yeah, we're still looking for Reginald, and I don't know when we're gonna find him, but when we do, it'll be good, I suppose. Maybe he's just a child, or maybe he's chosen each right now, who knows. Anyhow, that was that for Chapter 6. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be covering Chapter 7, The House. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.